Students, welcome to Saath Classes. So in this video, we are going to see how we can construct ray diagrams in case of lenses, that is concave lens and convex lens. In my previous video, I have shown how you can construct or draw the ray diagrams in case of the mirrors. And in this video, we will take to the next step, that in the case of lenses. So let's get started. So in front of me, I am having two lenses, that is convex lens and the concave lens. So I will start with the case number one, which is in the case of convex lens, how to draw the ray diagram. Let's get started. So before starting the video, I want to give a brief overview in what cases we are going to encounter while doing the refraction of convex lenses. So we are going to see six cases. Underline this thing, six cases, same in the case of the mirror, but that case for the concave mirror, but here it is convex lens. Okay, so just take care of this analogy. So now let's get started. So case number one, same, that our object is at infinity. So I will bring my object closer in every step. Now it is beyond C, that's something away from the center of curvature, and next I will bring my object at the center of curvature, that is C. Next case, I will bring it between C and F. The next case, I will bring my object much nearer, that is at focus. And the last case, which is case number six, I will bring my object between focus and optical center. So now let's get started with the case number one. So in case number one, I already told you in the previous video also, once more I am repeating here, that you have to write four things. So the first thing is about the object, and the remaining three things, that is image, size and the nature. It's with regard to the image. Okay, so the object position is always given to us in the exams normally, and we have to find where the image will form, what will be the size of the image, and what is the nature of the image. Now in case of my lenses, I have two regions, because the lens is a transparent medium. So I have focus one and center of curvature one of this part, and I have focus two, second focus and second radius of curvature, center of curvature for this curved path. Okay, so that's the only difference while constructing a lens and a mirror. So do take care of these things. And the distance between is same, between OF and CF, they are of equal distance. So now let's start with the first case, which is case number one. My object will be at infinity. So infinity, I consider it to be a sun, because the rays coming from the sun are generally parallel. So now I will take one ray at a time. The ray is parallel to the principal axis. So this line, if you can see, this black line is my principal axis. So if the ray passes through the focus, so in the rules we have already learned that it will pass through focus. But this medium is not a reflecting medium, it's a refracting medium. So the refraction will take place and the rays will pass through it, and it will pass through focus. It will pass through focus. After refraction, it will pass through focus. Now to form an image, I need minimum two rays. I will take another ray parallel to principal axis, because all the rays coming from infinity are parallel. So again, the same rule will apply and it will pass through focus. Now these two rays are cutting at F. These two green rays I have just demarcated with different colors. The red rays are before the refraction and the green rays are after the refraction. So just take care of this nomenclature throughout this video. So they are cutting at focus. So now my image is formed at focus. So I will write my image is formed at F2, because there are two focuses. So in order to get more clarity, so you can write down F2. And the size of the image is, it's a point size. So, or you can write highly diminished, both are correct. And the nature is real and inverted, because these images formed with the real rays. I have already told that the solid lines depict the real image, real rays. Okay, so the image will also be real. And the real image is always inverted. Do keep in mind. So now let's move on to my next case. In my next case, I will bring my object much closer. So it will be beyond C1. My object is now at beyond C1. So now let's start with a parallel ray. The parallel ray hit the lens, and after refraction, it will pass through focus. We already know this. I will take another ray. Let's pass this image from center of curvature. Let's pass this ray from optical center, and we know that if the ray passes through optical center, it moves straight without any deflection.
So it moves without any deflection. And the both green rays, if we can see both green rays, they are in solid color, solid green color. So they are real rays. Okay. The red rays are before the refraction. So they are cutting at this point and the image will be formed here. Okay. Now let's concentrate. The image is formed between F2 and C2. So I will write the image distances, or you can say image position is between F2 and C2. The size is diminished. Diminished means look at the size of this object and look at the size of this image. If you compare, the image size is smaller, or you can say diminished, both are correct. So the image will form, will be smaller in size as compared to the object. And the nature is inverted. If you can see, the image is inverted. So the real image is always inverted. So the option is the nature will be real and inverted. Let's move on to the case number 3. In case number 3, I will now move my object closer to the lens. Now I will place it at C1, that is center of curvature. We will apply the same two rules that we have already done. So a ray parallel to principal axis, after refraction it passes through focus. The second ray I will pass through optical center and it went undeflected. These two rays cut here and the image is formed. So the image is formed at exactly at C2. So I will write image is formed at C2. The size of the object and the size of the image are same. So I will write it as same size if you compare. Now the image is formed is inverted in nature, and we know that all the real image are inverted. So the nature will be real and inverted. Got it? So let's move on quickly to the case number 4. In case number 4, I will bring my object closer that I will place somewhere in between C1 and F1. Kahin bhi aap isko rakh sakte hain between C1 and F1. The result will remain the same. So in that case, I will put my object here. So the object is between C1 and F1. Again, applying the same law, parallel to principal axis, after refraction, it passes through focus. I will take another ray which passes through optical center. It went undeflected. Make a straight ray with a ruler. So they are cutting it here and the object is formed beyond C2. If you concentrate, image is formed beyond C2. So I will write image position is beyond C2. Now the size, if you compare the size of the object and the image size is larger. So the image is enlarged. It is enlarged and the nature is real and inverted. If you can see, it is inverted. So it will be real because it is formed by solid lines. Now in case number 5, I will bring my object much closer. That is, I will place it at focus or F1. Again, apply the same rule. Parallel to principal axis, after refraction, it passes through F2 or focus. I will draw another ray. It will pass through optical center and went undeflected. Now, if you see, these two rays are parallel, so they won't intersect. If I extend back, so it won't make any change. So the image is formed at infinity because they are not going to meet sooner. And the size will be highly enlarged because if you compare, they are not going to meet, so the size will be highly enlarged as compared to my object. So these two rays are real rays, so the image will be real and inverted. Okay, so let's move on to the case number 6. If you have any problem, any question, any query, you can put it in the comment box. Don't forget. Okay, and the last case, yes, it's a different case. As you compare in the mirror also, there is one case in which the image is formed virtual. So that's the case here. The image is formed virtual and they just mark down when the object is between focus and optical center. So it is the only case in which the image formed is virtual and erect. So let's see. And it's very important from the exam point of view. So again, first I will draw a ray parallel. I will use the same route and it will pass through focus. I will draw another ray which passes through optical center and it went undeflected, or you can say it went straight. No problem. Now, if you concentrate on these two lines, If I concentrate on these two lines are diverging in nature. So they won't be going to meet in the right direction. But if I extend these two lines in the left hand direction like this, if I extend this line in this direction, if I extend this line, dotted line means they are virtual lines. Dotted lines I already did, they are virtual line. I'm just extending it backwards. And if I extend this another line, this second line, so it seems to cut at this point. If I extend backward, it seems that they are cutting here, but they are not actually cutting. That's why they are virtual. Okay, so they are cutting here and the image is formed here. I have drawn a candle with a light shade. This means the image is also virtual, okay? Because it is made by two virtual lines. Therefore, the image is virtual, and if you can see, it is erect. It is straight, upright. So the image is formed between, behind the object. In every case, it will form behind the, if my object is there, so it can form here, here, but it will be behind the object. Kisi case mein seek ke peechha hi banegi, but it depends upon the position of the object. So we generalize it and we write it down that it always forms behind the object. And the size is enlarged. If I compare the size of the image, it is enlarged as compared to the object. And the nature is virtual and erect. So virtual image are always erect. So these are the six cases of convex lens. Let's move on to the case of concave lenses. So before starting, we have, this is the concave lens in front of us. Same C1, F1, F2 and C2. And this is the optical center. And we will study two cases in case of concave lens. So it's just the opposite of the mirror. In mirror, we have studied two cases of convex mirror. But here we are studying two cases of concave lens. Just take this thing into consideration. So the two cases will be when the object is at infinity, case number one, when the object is at infinity. And the second case, when it will be in front of the lens. So you can write, you can place it anywhere from infinity and between the lens. Kahin bhi aap isko place kar dijiye. So there are two cases. So let's start with the case number one. So case number one, my object will be at infinity. So I will take my infinity as sun, because sun rays are parallel. So our first ray coming parallel, and when it strikes, we have learned the rule also, when it strikes a parallel, ray strikes a lens, a concave lens, so it diverges, because concave lens is a diverging lens, it spreads out the light. But the convex lens is a converging lens, it converges the light. So the light is going to be diverged, and it appears that I am drawing the dotted line because it is a virtual line I am drawing. Backward, it won't go backward, because a ray, a lens is a transparent medium, so this ray won't go backward. So, but I am drawing for the sake of my rule, so it won't go backward. If I extend this dotted line like this, so this is the actual path. The green line is the actual path of the light. So the ray comes like this. After refraction, it passes like this. If I look from the focus, so it appears to be coming from focus. If I look from here, if I am standing, so it looks that this green ray is coming from focus. So that's the logic behind. So I will take another ray parallel to principal axis. After refraction, it appears to be come from the focus. And if I extend back, so if I look from here, if I place my eye here, so this green ray, it's appear to me as if it is coming from focus. Okay, so that's the only logic. So these two green rays are diverging rays. If they are extended backward, they are cutting at F1. But they are cutting with a dotted line, because these are the virtual lines. They are not the real lines. So the image will be virtual only. Okay. So the image will be formed at F, or you can say F1 or focus. The size will be, it will be a point size, or you can say highly diminished. And the nature will be, we know, since these are the two virtual lines, so it will be virtual and erect. So just take this thing into consideration. Let's move on to the case number two. I will bring my object. So place it anywhere in front of the lens. So I'm not generalizing it with the in front of the lens. You can place at C1 or beyond C, it doesn't matter. So you can place it in front of the lens anywhere. So let's start. A line parallel to principal axis. It appears to come from the focus. Same rule in the previous case. So if I look from here, it appears to be coming from the focus. Now I will take the second line. Let's take it from optical center, and it went undeflected. Okay. Now these two lines are cutting at this point. If I concentrate, they are cutting at this point. One is a virtual line and another is a real line. So if an image is cutting with a virtual and a real line, so we consider it to be a virtual only. Okay. So the image in this case is formed here, and its size is smaller than the object size, and it is virtual because one line is dotted. So it will be a virtual image. So image will be formed between F1 and O, means focus and optical center. The size is diminished, matlab chota hai object. And the nature, because it is formed by a virtual ray also, so that it will be virtual and erect. Virtual and erect. So these are the two cases of concave lens, and six cases we have already done for the convex lens. So So just go through them, draw them, practice them. And if you have any problem, just put it in the comment box. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. If you please like the video and share it to your friends. Thanks for watching Saath Classes.